think 2021 will mainly be known in the mainstream and like within the broader discussion of Doctor Who fandom as the year that Christopher Eccleston joined the annals of Big Finish and reprised his role as the Ninth Doctor to great acclaim and some wonderful box sets. But we also need to remember that in 2021, we got another Doctor as well joining the ranks of Big Finish, and that was Jonathan Carley, who this year has had two box sets. We had the first one earlier on in the year, Forged in Fire, which is like one of my favourite box sets of the entire year, and we've got their sequel now. We've got Volume 2, we've got Warbringer, which is another trilogy of stories, whereas Volume 1, Forged in Fire, was three standalone stories. Warbringer is now one three-hour epic event taking place early on in the Time War, with Jonathan Carley, of course, reprising his role as the War Doctor. And for those who have been listening to War Doctor box sets or Time War box sets generally, you'll also recognise Beth Chalmers as Commander Vecklin as well. Beth Chalmers is a mainstay in the Time War. Oh my god, they got Nick Briggs. I know, Nick Briggs is someone who is so rarely able to record these Dalek roles in these Time War box sets, where they somehow managed to wrangle him back in. We've got Consequences by Timothy X Attack, we've got Destroyer by Andrew Smith, and we've got Savior by Jonathan Morris. Louise Jameson, who also played Leela and directed the first box set, the first volume, is of course here to direct Volume 2 as well. And it's always just wonderful listening to her talk on the behind the scenes, on the making of, just talking about how much she loves directing actors and the performances in particular of this cast. And make no mistake, it's a really strong cast. I think the USP of this box set is the structure, at least that seems to be what they're going for in the behind the scenes, where I won't say which one, because that might amount to a minor spoiler. However, one of these stories is not in chronological order. Three episodes, but one of them is not taking place linearly, if that makes sense. Let's say, for example, Consequences is the beginning of the story. No, Consequences is the middle chapter. Destroyer is the first and Savior is the last. Like, I'm just, that's not exactly how it goes down, but I'm just saying as an example. It does that interesting timey-wimey thing, which is fun and playful. Whether or not it actually sticks the landing, however, is another thing entirely. But what we'll do real quick is that we'll play a clip, because in my opinion, the main reason to check out these box sets is to listen to Jonathan Carley's incredible performance as the War Doctor. And this is a clip from part one, Consequences, where the War Doctor needs to get across a battlefield really, really quickly. He lands on a planet, he crash lands on a planet with Vecklin, a cultish planet which uses war as a religion, as their main sacred texts, and it's their lifestyle, it's their religion, and he has to try and stop war on a planet that is all about war. He needs to get onto the other side of this battlefield, and he's riding massive robots. Let's play a quick clip.
Ah, gentlemen! You're like a well-oiled machine. In fact, that's exactly what you are. Oh, look! We have a village full of witnesses. Wave hello as you pass by. Let's keep this myth buoyant, shall we? Who will tell the truth of war?
Warbringer and Savior.
Who shall freeze the sun in the sky?
Warbringer and Savior.
Who has most likely bitten off far more than he can chew? The gods are fallible, ladies and gentlemen. Remember that. Even if they listen to you, Warbringer, what are you going to tell them?
So what I love about these War Doctor Begins box sets is that they don't just say, let's just get the dour, downbeat John Hurt Doctor and just put him on in these stories and call it a day. They do have a more fun, lighthearted, not exactly carefree Doctor, but someone who is definitely early on and young in this regeneration, who still has the optimism there before the Time War just beats out of him. And I love that that is the angle that Jonathan Carley appears to have taken in portraying this role. This is a War Doctor who is trying to uphold his promise of being the Doctor, even though he doesn't use that name anymore. He's trying to do it in spirit, even if he's not necessarily carrying the moniker. And I think that clip really, really demonstrated it. Like, who has bitten off more than they can chew? Warbringer. But just exactly who is the titular Warbringer is a matter of debate in terms of this box set, but of course I'll say no more. But what... my favourite part about this box set, though, Warbringer, is that this isn't necessarily a War Doctor-led story. This is more, who could a potential companion be for a Doctor who was born in fire, who was forged in fire, I should say, who was born in order to fight the Time War? And that's where we find this character, Case, played by Ajaz Awad, who we'll see on the cover here, this sort of like cybernetic character, who is sort of our audience surrogate, more or less, or at least one of the main points of view characters for this box set. Someone who is hearing robotic voices in her head, who has had her memory wiped, and we don't quite know who she is, what her deal is, who her alliances are, but she was much like the War Doctor, someone who was born in, who was forged in fire, who was born for warfare, born for combat. And the Doctor obviously sees a bit of himself in Case. Case is a play on words where the War Doctor names her Case. The origins of the name I'll leave for the box set itself to explain, should you want to pick it up. But it was a really lovely performance. You've got Ajaz Awad playing both Case normally as herself and also playing Case in a Case, I think they call her in the credits, as the voice in her head, the voice in her mind. It's a really great polar opposites in terms of the performances. But she is basically the quintessential War Doctor companion, somebody who is who the Doctor is able to relate to and is trying to guide down a better path, regardless of her origins or of the means of her creation. But once again, the actual creation itself and her means and what she's been ordered to do, what she's been born to do, I won't spoil for you here. Whether or not it actually pans out in terms of the non-linear story, however, I think is slightly less successful. It might seem a bit presumptuous on my part, but it wouldn't surprise me if they just had this trilogy of stories and they thought relatively late in the game, what if we just moved one of these stories into a different position? It just seems a bit, it feels like that approach, even though during the behind the scenes they're talking about how that's one of the key aspects of the story. But what I did was that when the order of the story was revealed, I did listen to this box set again in chronological order, and it didn't quite line up. It didn't quite add up in terms of, in particular, the beginning chapter introduces a character and acts like we should have always known who he was. And it almost feels like that episode of Rick and Morty where the household is just besieged by this assortment of supporting characters, this assortment of people who are have infiltrated their memories. It felt a little bit like that, and then he's just sort of hand waved away. But the actual the pre-credit sting of what is revealed to be the second chapter does not line up with what happened in the prior chapter, and it just confused me a bit. It does feel a little bit like a last minute decision, but that probably wasn't the case, but that was kind of how it came across. The actual structure of the story itself felt a bit like an afterthought. Thankfully, the story itself and the moral dilemma that the War Doctor is put through is interesting, is compelling, is performed incredibly well. And the cast are uniformly great. It's, of course, as usual, lovely just to hear Beth Chalmers as Vecklin. Vecklin is just a real piece of work who's trying her best in a time war. And I'm always here for it. I'm always here to listen to it. I really liked it. There's some really great Dalek action as well. The Daleks are way more prominent in this story than they were in the last box set, Forged in Fire. But what I liked about this was that this was a trilogy. This was a massive 3-hour story that just kept on getting worse in terms of the situation for the Doctor and the stresses that he was put under as it went along. And it was great to see Carly's performance adapt to that as well. Honestly, if it wasn't for the fact that I've spoken to Carly and I've interviewed him and I've had him on stream, and I know that this is not John Hurt. If it wasn't for that, I'd close my eyes, zone out. This is John Hurt once again reprising the role. It's a really thoughtful performance. It's just great to hear it as well. And it's also, it's not just a carbon copy. The War Doctor Begins War Doctor is clearly different from the actual War Doctor that we're seeing with John Hurt, like I said, where he's way more optimistic and trying to do the right thing, who this planet that they land on is about to undergo an apocalypse-level event, and he's trying to find the right way through it. And whether or not he's able to, of course, that's for the box set to let you know. This is a really strong sequel to Forged in Fire. I think that Forged in Fire had a few more moments where, like, I'm audibly gasping while listening to it, and it's really taken me on an emotional journey. Forged in Fire has got Lionhearts by Lou Morgan, and Lionhearts is, oh my goodness, that's one hell of an emotional trip. Warbringer isn't quite an emotional trip like that, but the fact that it was able to so effectively tell a 3-hour Time War story and kept me on the edge of my seat throughout, and I was enjoying it all the way through, even though the structure I don't think entirely worked. It was one hell of a listen. I won't spoil the order, but this feels like something where you could listen to it in chronological order and more or less get the same experience, but it still was really effective. I really, really liked Warbringer. The more I think about it, the more I like it. This has been a really bloody good month for Big Finish. They have really, like, ended 2021 on a really high note. So, there's only so much I can say without outright spoiling stuff. Of course, I'm kind of skirting around the edges here. But if you folks are interested in Time War stuff at all, or if you liked the first box set, Warbringer is a very easy recommendation. And I definitely recommend Forged in Fire, though. Forged in Fire is like a terrific set. Ollie Thomason Music says, what would you say is a good War Doctor jumping on point? So, the best way to jump onto the War Doctor is to watch a little-known TV story called The Day of the Doctor. All right, Winnie. Come on down. Winnie, can you even get down from there? She can do it.
Good.
But no, in all seriousness, for Big Finish stuff, you can't go wrong with either Only the Monstrous, which is the first War Doctor box set. I don't think it's the best of the four. I think that's Agents of Chaos. Agents of Chaos is so bloody good. Or Forged in Fire. You know, either of those two. You can listen to them in story order. I think Agents of Chaos is the best, but you don't have to listen to the prior installments, but I think because of the relationship between the War Doctor and the Cardinal... Cardinal Lystra, is it? Yeah, Cardinal Lystra by the late, great Jacqueline Pierce. Seeing that unfold and play out over the course of these box sets, that's just a delight to listen to.